What's up, guys? Tastosis is back, and we have our final best of three today. It's going to be SOS against Trap, but Protoss versus Protoss. The loser is out of the GSL code as the winner goes on to the round of eight.
Well, both these players obviously want that round of eight so, so badly. Trap kind of killed SOS off. Like, I feel like he outclassed him in a lot of ways. He outthought him. He outmicroed him in those two games. But that does not mean it's going to look like that again. PvP is a funny matchup like that.
PvP is a tricky matchup, man. It's a lot of instinct involved in as far as what strategy you're going to choose. Mm-hmm. You know? SOS and Trap here. Now, Trap, if you missed earlier on, you're just now joining us. Trap 2-0'd SOS.
Yes. Yes, he did.
Yes. You give me that look, I'm like, they did, right?
Yeah.
Like, am I making this up?
Nah.
Trap with very aggressive play. One game of proxy. The question is, what is Trap going to do this time? You know, Trap's a pretty sneaky player. But, you know, you can only trick somebody so many times before they know all of your traps. Oh, my God. That was actually... I did not even mean that to be a pun, but that was a pun.
Mm-hmm. Well, thing is, the Trap's going kind of a cyclical fashion. A tactical wheel, some might say.
That's true.
So it can be hard even if you know them all. Got to figure out which one it is.
Looks like our game is now going to load up. It all comes down to this one moment. Who can come with the best PvP here between these two? SOS and Trap here at the GSL Code S. I'm excited for the way my heart is beating. I'm gonna need a riot squad to help control my breathing. Communicating with faces like I can hear it speaking. Over here in the south, ready to exact his revenge. He is.
Woongjin Stars SOS.
He was not strong enough to defeat Rain, but he's strong enough to defeat SOS again. He is.
Soul Trap.
Well, sounds like a jazz band or something.
Soul Trap?
Yeah. Or maybe a like hardcore band or something like that.
Hardcore band?
Could be. Like someone in it would scream for sure.
Yeah. There's this band name. I never even heard the band's music, but it was like one of these hardcore bands.
Mm-hmm.
Like hardcore, like screaming, like, like music, like.
Just like that.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And the band's name was Nausea. And I was like, that's such a good band name.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
That's pretty good, actually.
There's actually a band.
Considering like the genre music, I'm like, that's pretty well picked.
There was a German band that actually stole my name for a while. They came out after me, called Artosis, and then I outlived them.
What?
Yeah. There was a German band for called Artosis. It was after made the name, though. Because they actually had... Yeah, they
came out themselves after you?
Well, no. I'm sure that they just thought that up themselves as well. That would be really weird if they named it after StarCraft 1 player.
But, I mean, Artosis isn't even, like, a thing. Like,
I know.
When you made it up. It's like...
I don't know.
A name...
But they did. It was real. It's true. They no longer exist, as far as I know.
Is it possible Artosis is like a word in some language or something like that?
No, it's not a word anywhere. I've done Google searches.
That's actually freaky.
Yeah.
That's like proof that like there are only so many ideas we can have. That one guy in New Hampshire trying to think up and how to name himself in a game. And meanwhile, somewhere else in Germany at some point in time on Earth, both were like, all right, what are we going to call ourselves? And he's like,
Maybe they were just big Taren
Tootie.
Fans.
Tootie, and he's like, no. And they scribble that one out of the book. He's like, R2. And he's like, no. That doesn't do it. And someone's like, Artosis. Then the other guy says, wait a minute. Hold on a minute. Artosis.
Yeah.
It's you know what?
Sick.
Yeah. It sounds like a hip disease. I like it, man.
Well. So.
We got Sarko coming out here now.
You flatter me, Tasteless.
And Mothership Core now out. And we have a Twilight Council coming up here for Trap.
Nice quick one there.
Yep.
Zealot and a Sentry already out. I'm leaning towards that being a DT
build right there.
Well, he's in such a hurry to get that Twilight Council out, you know?
Certainly. A very quick one, and kind of skipped the early Stalker, which doesn't actually mean anything either way. But he's never mind. He's actually saved so much chrono, that has to be Blink. Yeah, there's no way. That has to be Blink.
We got the Stalker coming up here now, by the way.
Oh,
nice! Well, oh, I thought the Zealot had pinned it. I thought it had got pinned.
Yeah, if you have a pin there, then that's fantastic.
So quick, make a Dark Shrine. You got to do something to trick him fast.
Well, now we might see SOS go for that Dark Shrine, because this is a really quick Blink upgrade. And the fact that he went for the early Sentry and Zealot with it, this is kind of an interesting thing that we're seeing. Now, Trap adding a couple gateways on right away. He's going to want to get this underway. For SOS, though, I mean, he's completely fine. The thing is, you have to... Oh, my God. Yes, he's going charge. This is so cool.
Oh, yeah. The charge would be great against this. You know, it's a bunch of Zealots out. I mean, he blinks away, and it doesn't matter because the Zealots just get over there.
Well, charge Zealots do end up beating Blink Stalkers, especially if you're on two bases or three bases. And he is proxying that Dark Shrine. So it's going to be like he'll probably bust through any force fields with a single Archon when he goes to attack and whatnot. But the thing is about this build, if the Blink player controls it just right, and he is getting his robotics as well, Blink Stalker up to a certain number beats the Zealots. So we'll just... we just have to see how it goes. Like, how aggressive does Trap get? How well does he whittle everything down? Because SOS is really smart the way he's doing this. He's making a lot of Stalkers. Because if you just go into pure Zealot here, the Stalkers beat you right off. But if you have the Stalkers as well, it's going to be very hard to micro against. I actually really like the way SOS is doing this, because I used to do a build exactly like this, and I had a hard time. But those Stalkers are kind of brilliant. The fact that he has five out right now.
Yeah.
So smart. Oh, my God.
Okay. Finds one pylon over here. Yeah, he is out hunting for anything. In fact, I think he's gonna spot this. Nope. He turns around at the last second.
Well, we do have SOS walking out across the map. He does have charge, and only Stalkers as units. It's pretty funny.
Okay, here comes the DT now. Now this is gonna get shut down pretty easily here.
Oh. Okay, so it does get shut down. We should see Zealots start to get warping in immediately. There we go. Starting to get some Zealots here is SOS. I wonder with how many Stalkers you made, how he's out.
Oh, you know
map.
What? This is actually going to get intercepted.
Yeah, he's basically dead, I would say.
Yeah. That's wow. Quick tap.
Okay,
up.
There's a couple things I'm confused about. Like, the thing is, like, C and B are not next to each other. I'm trying to figure out if he could have accidentally gotten charged. But charge can go with DT. Like, it's,
well, the other question is not, what does he have his hotkeys set to? But
yeah, that's, you know, being a
well,
player
here's
from Starcraft
weird.
1.
Like, oh yeah, well we couldn't actually change in Starcraft 1. We couldn't change our hotkeys.
Yeah, I imagine his keys are C and B for those. I really think that they're probably C and B. I wonder if that was a mistake, the charge, because it kind of made sense to make a certain number of Stalkers and make sure he couldn't just kill you by out-blinking your Zealots. But he never made them, and then his Stalkers were across the map, which made zero sense. So I feel like that may have just been a mistake.
Well, I mean, he had enough Stalkers.
I mean, he had Blink in his defensive
logically,
at home.
You when you're investing in an upgrade, you're simultaneously investing in the units of that upgrade uses. So... I mean, that was a weird situation where we had this guy who was going for charge. We're like, oh, cool, okay. And then as we watch it unfold, he has a bunch of Stalkers that are moving freely around the map. And when you move Stalkers freely around the map like that, you assume the person's getting Blink, because that way they can get away if they get stuck, you know?
Yeah, yeah. The moving across the map is what really made no sense. So I guess we're going to chalk that one up to SOS accidentally got the wrong upgrade.
It happens, man. All right, SOS needs to come back, or Trap is going to close us out with a 2-0 here in our final best of three to see who is going to be the final person to get to round of eight here today. GSL Codes at GOMTV.net.